He, of course, is a policy analyst at the Show Me Institute. Didn't you get a raise or a new title?
Got a new title.
What's your new title?
Policy analyst.
Policy analyst. Okay, that is your new title. All right, good.
Was a researcher, now an analyst.
All right, good.
Don't forget it.
You went in for a raise, and they said, sorry, we can't give you a raise, but we can give you another title. It's you took the title.
The nonprofit world is tough.
All right, Graham Renz, you have a problem with community improvement districts. Why are you against our community trying to improve itself?
Well, it would be nice if it was just that, but just imagine there's a law that lets you, McGraw, tax people in St. Charles to pay for your own bills, right? It would be fantastic. That'd
yes.
be great. We'd all have one.
Yes.
Well, you don't have to imagine it. That's Missouri's CID or Community Improvement District law, and essentially that allows you to, or a developer or property owner, whoever, to
yes.
establish a district, charge a sales tax, and use that tax money to pay for your own bills.
And anybody can do this?
More or less, a single property owner can establish one of these districts. And there's some examples we know throughout the area, but more or less how these things are created, you just form a petition. Property owners can be just a single property owner, just to charge a sales tax, to build all sorts of things on your property throughout the quote-unquote community that supposedly have public benefits. But oftentimes, we see these go for private uses.
Where is the check and the balance? Does it have to go to the voters? Does it have to be signed off on?
That's just it. A single property owner can establish one of these districts, just like TDDs or transportation development districts, which we've talked about before. But if you're not a constituent in the district, you essentially don't get to vote on whether you raise your taxes, how that tax money is spent. So if you're a residential property owner just down the road from a strip mall, that strip mall can create one of these. Since you're not a constituent, you don't get to vote. But every time you shop in that district, you're going to pay that extra tax to go for whatever it is that property owner wants that money to go to.
So very similar to the transportation development districts.
Yep. Just very, very similar. CIDs or community improvement districts can pay for a broader range of things,
but not just transportation.
It's just another ingredient in corporate welfare subsidy soup here in Missouri.
How have these been abused over the last number of years?
That's a great question, and that's what we're looking into at the Show Me Institute. So, the law that let these things get established was in 1998. So since 1998 till today, there are at least 275 of these districts across the state.
275?
275. So there was an audit, an auditor's report in April that looked at TDDs, and that said there was about 205. There's even more CIDs than there are TDDs. And just from 2014 to 2016, my fantastic intern Grace helped me compile this information. CIDs have collected and spent $146 million over that three-year period.
Wow.
$146 million that most people had no clue that they were paying.
Right. So what are some of the CIDs out there?
So some notable ones here in the St. Louis region is the second phase of Ballpark Village,
right.
It already got TIF and all sorts of other stuff, but they were allowed to establish a CID on just their property to charge an extra 1% sales tax that's going to go right back to the Cardinals
right.
to help pay for that development.
Okay.
Out in Chesterfield, one of the outlet malls, St. Louis Premium Outlets, they have both a TDD and a CID that charge extra sales taxes to help pay for their own bills.
So the consumer can say, I don't want to shop at Ballpark Village, therefore I won't help fund it.
That would be true. I mean, that's true, but oftentimes there is no placard outside that says you're paying an extra 1% sales tax here to
right.
help pay for this district.
Right.
And that highlights one of the big issues with these districts is because there's very few constituents. Sometimes there's only one. You can't audit these things. It was just in 2016 that the state auditor had the power to audit CIDs, because before that, you had to be a constituent of a district
mm-hmm.
to generate an audit. But because so few of these things have any residents as constituents, property owners just set them up. Because there were no residential constituents, there was never an audit done of any of these.
So how loose is this? Can I get a bunch of homeowners between me and downtown Cottonville and create some type of district, put a tax on the businesses of Cottonville and just split the money between the four of us and say, hey, we're trying to make a better sidewalk?
Yep, you can do that, right? So if you wanted to build sidewalks, you can, but you can fund all sorts of things. And if the city that you're in declares that the property or the area is quote-unquote blighted,
right,
you can use the money for pretty much anything. In Kansas City, a luxury hotel, the Intercontinental Hotel, said that it was blighted, got a blight designation from the city.
Right.
And this is a luxury hotel. We're talking almost $200 a night. Got a CID and can use that CID money to pay for renovating its rooms, redoing its parking garage. It allows for these self-serving projects.
Right. I was in Omaha when they announced that Warren Buffett's house was in a blighted area.
Yeah. I mean, technically, you look at the statute, the word blight, it applies to every single property in the state of Missouri. And so it's easy to get one of these blight designations and then to charge one of these extra taxes. And so it's just, it's unfair. We can think of these scenarios where you're building sidewalks and making downtown pretty, but these districts allow for so much more than that. They allow for private businesses to tax the public for private gain.
But do I need, in that scenario, do I need the city's approval, or can I just go and do this on my own?
So we don't need to get too far into the weeds, but just like with a TDD, you petition the circuit court or the county court. With a CID, you petition the city clerk of the city you're in. So you file a petition with the city, and then the city says, they have a hearing and they say you're created or you're not created, the district. But then voters get to vote on the taxing mechanism.
So anybody talking about this? Anybody wanting to do away with this? It seems like this is just taxes for the super wealthy who can take care of politicians along the way.
So it's nice if you know these laws exist and you know how to use them, right? And you're in the development world. But again, so few people even know these things exist or that they're paying these taxes. So just to give you an idea, when we were compiling this information on CID spending, there was a spreadsheet, a list of about 325 financial reports on the auditor's website, and you have to click through every single one and hope that it's up to date. And that is the most comprehensive data we have on these districts. Right. I thank my intern Grace. I had her just click through all these data points, compile all this information, and that's the best we have.
Also, too, with this sales tax, as you mentioned this time and time again, sales tax, right? Another 1% here, another 10% there, another 8%. All of a sudden, you're getting 10, 11, 12% in sales tax.
Yeah. In parts of St. Louis City, let's say these two, the zoo sales tax and the police sales tax goes forward, gets approved in November, the base rate's going to be 9.8%. And then you slap on an extra 2% for TDDs and CIDs, you're almost, what is that? Was that almost 12%?
Right.
And then you got a 1.5% restaurant sales tax. Your bill's going to be a whole lot bigger than you think it is. And it's not going to pay for the roads, right? It's going to somebody's private business.
Right. Yeah. No, and that's why people are shopping online, because I go to Amazon and they don't charge me 12%. You know,
CIDs haven't found a way to infect the internet yet. So
can we read more online?
Absolutely. You can go to our website at showmeinstitute.org.
Interesting world. Graham Renz. Rooting out interesting things we don't know along the way. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you much.
All right, 8:45 here, Big 550, KTR.